church.
My name is Daniel Buyo. I'm going to share with you a word from the book of Lamentations, chapter number 3, verse 39 to 42. And I'll read. Why should any living man complain when punished for his sins? Let us examine our ways and test them, and let us return to the Lord. Let us lift up our hearts and our hearts to God in heaven and say, we have sinned and rebelled, and you have not forgiven us. Let us pray. Our dear loving God, we want to thank you so much, because you have given us good memories to remember where we've come from, where we are. Also, we pray that you help us to see where we are going. Even as we listen to your word, talk to us individually and collectively. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. This book of Lamentation is a very interesting book, because these are records of lamentations of Jeremiah over Jerusalem. And they had sinned against God, and they were punished by being taken hostage or slaves to Babylon. And now Jeremiah is crying over them. And what I like about Jeremiah's lamentation is they were accompanied by prayers. So our lamentations today, because there are many with a lot of sorrows, but we have forgotten where we received our salvation. Where did you, or did I, receive my salvation? And between that time and now, can I be able to find out, just like a parent disciplines the children to produce right behavior? It is also possible that God, being our Father, will discipline us to produce right living and to make us worship God. So let us learn from discipline that we've received even at this particular moment, rather than complaining about discipline. Let us, I urge you, my brothers and sisters, let us learn to trust God. Let us be intentional to change. And let us remember that this may be as God's way of correcting our behavior. So my brothers and sisters, I want to encourage you right now with the words that we have learned of sorrow and lamentation, and urge you kindly, do not stop at the sorrow and lament. Remember where you received your salvation. I was reading a book from Titus chapter 3, Titus chapter 3, verse 4 and 5. I will request you to read on your own. Titus chapter number 3, reading verses 4, verses 4 and 5, and as I said that you read for yourself, it is simply a reminder of the great salvation between us and God. And the word that we read in the Lamentation reminds us two, three things that we must examine our ways. We must test our ways, and we must return to the Lord. And returning to the Lord and examining our ways and testing our ways can also be rounded up with one word: repent. Because I feel it may not be so that we received. We need to repent. We need to repent. We need to know where we received our salvation from. That is at the cross of Jesus. So as I encourage each one of you, and I also get discouraged, I ask you and urge you kindly, please go back to the cross. When we go back to the cross, what do we find? What do we find at the cross? We find the love of God. We find the love of God. So, many years since you are saved, many years you've probably been doing contrary to what God wants. And therefore, right now, like I said about parents who display their children to produce right behavior, I don't know, and I'm not competent enough to make a judgment, but I'll say parents display their children to produce right behavior. God, in the same way, displayed Israel to produce right behavior. And that God of that time is the same God we have right now and here. And I will not be ashamed of saying that it is probably His way of disciplining us and making us go back to the cross, go back to the love of Jesus Christ at the cross. I go back there, I find a lot of love, my mind is aroused so easily by that. So remember, there is great salvation even at this time of coronavirus. And it is not even equal or anywhere near the love of God. May God help us, members, as we examine ourselves, as we test ourselves, as we turn to the God, to our God, independence. May God bless you. Amen. Let us pray. Our dear loving God, we pray that you help us. Help us to go back. To go back to the place where we received our salvation. That is at the cross. And when we get back there, there is a lot of love between one another, between us and God. And I'm sure God is going to do something even at this time if we go back to Him. And this is my prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.